We have an old saying at Apple, it's the best way to predict the future is to invent it.
You have automation that could take away jobs, technology that'll take away jobs. The developer community seems like a very ripe place for people to want to invest. So how do you guys at Apple try to get people invested in developing apps, developing this kind of technology at an early age?
This is such an important topic. We've been thinking about everything from how do you help kids learn to code in school? How do you create a developer program where anybody can sign up for free, get the tools, and learn to be a developer? How do you have an app store where anyone can post their app and instantly everyone in the world can download it and create a business opportunity for you? One of the cool things that I'm really proud that we're working on is an education program. We call it Everyone Can Code. It actually is a little play off of the Anyone Can Cook from Ratatouille, that movie. And it's kind of the same thing. You know, anyone can cook, not everyone will be a chef. Anybody can learn to code, not everybody will be the world's greatest app developer. And we all grew up where you have to learn a foreign language. I think increasingly it's really important that people learn to code. And even if you don't become a developer later in life, chances are your job is going to interact with a software programmer and you're going to want to be able to have a dialogue at an intelligent level because you understand where they're coming from.
Looking at developers and this idea of creativity, and if you look at the iPhone, which is almost like this canvas for creativity, where did your creativity stem from?
I have had a lot of interest through the years. I was a drummer for decades in every style of music. I studied a fair amount of art growing up as a student. So I like to think that there's a few genes in there that are creative in the mix of what make me up. So I heard someone once say, developers are the new rock stars. And I think that's true. I think that they're culturally doing amazing things. They're just fascinating people doing things that impact our lives. And there's no part of our life that isn't touched by apps now.
Okay, so let's fast forward 10 years into the future. What role does Apple play in our lives?
No one knows what a span like 10 year brings. It's really hard to predict the future that far in advance. We have an old saying at Apple, it's the best way to predict the future is to invent it. Right? So if you want to know what the future is, well, what are we trying to do? We believe deeply in an iPhone and an iPad and Mac and these tools that help empower people to do things they never thought possible. I think the biggest group that's empowered now today is app developers. So we need to create the tools and technology to envision that future where we're all using AR apps all the time. All of our apps leverage machine learning, and they're doing things that none of us can imagine right now because it takes these tens of millions of developers to dream them up for us. So you have to bootstrap them and give them that capability. And that's what this is all about here at WWDC, giving them the tools they need to go invent the things that none of us would have thought of.